Okay. You guys ready for the most chaotic stream I've ever done? I have zero plan for the day. I'm sort of just winging it. I got some new clay I kind of want to try out. My dolls need to be changed into winter clothes. And that's it. That's the entirety of my organization for the day. I have nothing else planned. I'm going to be winging it. You guys want to see what I got in my... I got an advent calendar this year. I've never had an advent calendar before, so that was kind of cool. So far, I got Universal Machine Needles. I got pretty standard, you know, not super fancy hand sewing kit. I don't know. I got, like, sticky stuff from... Something had a sticker on it. Whoops! Okay, so I got machine needles. I think that was day two. This was day three. It's a threader, but it has also thread cutters. And I believe it works for yarn, too, because it's got the really, really big one, which is usually for threading yarn or tapestry needles. But I'm thinking this is going to be really helpful for doing doll rooting when I use the yarn hair that I have to thread through those tapestry needles. Because it actually broke all of my other threaders. You know, the little thin wire ones? All of those, I snapped three of them. But I think that this is because it's a little more substantial than a wire threader. I think this could be really useful for threading that yarn hair for rooting doll scalps. So I think that's going to be awesome. And then I got another pretty standard tool. I got a thimble. And another standard tomato pincushion with a little strawberry on the end. And then this is my favorite so far. I posted this on TikTok yesterday because when I opened it, I was giggling at this for like 10 minutes straight. It's a tape measure. It's got inches on one side. There's the inches side. And then millimeters on the other. And I only have one other measuring tape that has millimeters, so that's actually pretty useful because I can keep this one in my purse now and keep the other one that I have on my table. So, my little froggy tape measure. I love it. And then this was today's. It's a marking pencil, which you can never have too many marking tools. So far this has been a really fun advent calendar. And even if the tools end up being, like, only just worth the price of the calendar, so far I've been having fun with it. And, like, I haven't been having a fun year. So anything that makes me feel a little bit better is worth the money, in my opinion. Okay, so back to my dolls. I need to put everybody's winter clothes on. And I really need to glue this girl's scalp down. I bought her from a friend, and she sent her with two different scalps in case I wanted to change it. But this is the one I really like on her. I have to glue it down because it falls out every time I take her hat off. But okay. I didn't grab her a new hat. She may just wear the same one. I think that'll be okay. But obviously she's, you know, still in the Halloween clothes, and I'm gonna put them in their winter stuff today. Because I have her, Shelly, and Emily, and
they live on my front bookshelf, so they need to be dressed up nice.
I'm gonna give you this one, and you this one, and no. I actually like those tights better. Okay. So, she's going to get this one. Thank you. I've been nerding out over the birds in my backyard the last few days. We got a new pair of birds yesterday that I hadn't seen before. So I looked them up. They're called tufted titmouse. Well, I guess plural is tufted titmice. So my mom called them mouse birds today. So I'm calling them mouse birds now. But they're really cute. We have cardinals. We have finches. Some pigeons, blue jays. We have, like, a lot of birds because I live fairly close to the woods. So I get a lot of wildlife in my backyard. I am gonna miss that if we move somewhere that isn't close to woods because I really enjoy it. Okay, so a lot of the hats I have are from my friend Anthony. Oh my gosh, this is so cute. Look at this. So she's gonna get this one because I think this one's gonna be big enough to go over all of her hair. She does have a lot of it, and I love it. Oh, it just fits. She really just has so much hair. Alright. So there's one down. Put her aside. And Emily. Was one of my only dolls in my collection that I did not make. Other than Shelly and Persephone over here, who I will get to. Emily, I actually won at my first virtual Blythe convention. And she is made by Heidi Corley Bardo. And the dress that was on her, that's one that I made, and I have, I think, still one with this fabric in my shop, and I can make more as custom orders at any time, so any doll people who join my stream, hey, first time chatter, thank you! It's a little faded right now. I'm actually going to have to touch it up either today or tomorrow. There we go. But, yeah, it's sort of an ombre. Because when I bleached the mids, I didn't use, like, a really strong bleach this time because I wanted it to be a little bit darker. And it came out like an ombre yellow with the green, which I kind of like, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to replicate that or not. Yeah, thank you. I appreciate that. I've been letting it go because I really like the ombre that happened by accident, and I don't want to die over it. I like it. So I'm setting these girls up because I'm going to do a Christmas photo shoot with dolls. And I want them to be dressed and ready to go. There we go. Get her hat tied on her. So that's another hat from Anthony. So Anthony, if you're watching, Emily's got your stuff on this time.
These two sit on a little bench.
a bookshelf in the front of my house. So, I'm back on my bench. Okay. There's two down. And this one is Persephone, and I got her in a doll swap, and I think she is one of the prettiest dolls I have ever seen, to be honest. I just adore her. And she, well, I have to take her hands off first, because she's going to get this, the floofy sweater, and I don't want her little fingers to catch all the way down. I also made her dress. I think I sold out of the ones in my shop in this fabric, but that's another one that I can definitely make more of. I was debating if I was going to put a little skirt on under this sweater, but I kind of like it how it is. So I think I'm going to leave just like that and keep her hands off for now. Over there. And then I've got to change my twins. These two are my shop mascots. So, I usually have them matching, but I don't have. What are we stuck on? We're just caught on our hips. I don't have matching outfits planned for them right now, so. I did not make these dresses. These were sent to me. They were part of my Halloween doll swap this year. Okay. So, this one's Abby. Abby's done. I'm gonna keep her little bat turban on, because I think it kind of goes with the Grinch and Nightmare Before Christmas sweater. So. I have to wrap up my clay after I open it. Oh no! Hold on, I just knocked over my ring light.
I have a ring light off to the side, which I'm not used to having because it's been getting dark before my stream ends.
Okay, there we go. It's not part of my normal setup, so I'm not used to having to avoid the little legs of the ring light. No, her boot is untied. I hate tying these tiny things.
Because they're both going to be wearing
outfits that I got from the same seamstress. And I have these little sweatpants that came with this one, but I'm saving those because my first boy doll should be getting here any day now. And I think those would work really well for him. So, let me put her little sweater on first. Oh, I hope I can get it over her boots, because I don't want to take them off. After I just tied them. Yeah. I love being able to take the hands off of these jointed bodies. It makes it so much easier to dress them. Okay. Make sure I'm putting them on the right arms. I see a lot of Monster High dolls for sale, especially on eBay, that have the hands put on the wrong arms, and it just drives me crazy. Like, I want to reach through the screen and fix their poor hands. Silly with this outfit just because of where the shirt fits. So I'm gonna give the belt to Abby instead. They're my twins, so they share clothes all the time. They won't mind. Both of their outfits were made by my friend Mags. I don't know that Mags watches my streams, but just in case, there they are. Okay. So, everybody's dressed now. Now I can focus on the clay. And the first thing that I kind of want to do with this clay is I have this little... there we go. My camera's on the wrong side of the table today, too, because of the light. Okay, so I have this little table, and it had really... I mean, I think you can tell that the knobs were not centered on any of these drawers. So I ripped the knobs off, and I'm gonna patch those areas and make new knobs with the clay. So... I'm going to try that today with this Sculpey clay. I'm hoping that it'll be easier to work with than epoxy, because epoxy, it starts out so sticky that it's too hard to make anything this small. Like, I'm not that good at working with it yet. And my other air dry clay is a paper clay, so it just doesn't stick to other things very well. So I want to try this Sculpey clay and see if it's any better. Because obviously I want to do that before I paint the drawers. Okay, so I'm going to open it. I've never used Sculpey Air Dry before, but it had really good reviews online. So I'm hoping this is going to work for what I want. And obviously I'm not going to need this whole huge block, so I have my plastic wrap ready to go. Take a piece of plastic wrap off. I want it nice and big because I want to wrap it around at least twice. If I can get it around three times, that would be ideal. So I want to take off just a really small piece to start with, because I just kind of want to get a feel for it. So I'm gonna take my X-Acto here and just carve off like a little corner. Oh my god, that gummed up my X-Acto so bad. Oh no. That doesn't bode well. Or maybe it does, because I don't know, maybe that means it's really good and sticky. And it'll stick to my little table. So, to preserve this, I like to stick the plastic down and just sort of flop it. And then flop it again. Pull it tight. And then pull the edges over really tight. I actually think that there's not quite enough on this edge to fold it that way, so I'm going to do like a gift wrap. Fold one half down and this half up, and then pop it in the bag. Well, I hope it fits in this bag. I didn't want to get a really big bag because I hate using up all the really big bags in the house for my clay, but I don't know that it's going to fit in a little one. I think I have to get a bigger bag, so let me go grab a bigger bag. Big bag. Okay. So before you close the bag, you have to make sure that all of the air is out. So, just like with the plastic, I just kind of roll it as tight as I can. There we go. Okay. And then I do this so that I know which clay is which. Okay. So I just took a little bit out because I've never used this clay before. I kind of just want to figure out how it behaves before I take too much of it out. Because some air dry clay stays tacky for a while, and some dries out really, really quickly, so I'm just going to try and patch my holes first. Patching really well, so that's something. It is really sticky though, like it's sticking to my hands a lot. I don't know if maybe putting some lotion on my hands would help. Let me just try and keep smoothing it on here first. So I got this little table from the dollar store, so obviously it's not, like, super high quality. But my thought process was I can patch up the imperfections and for a dollar still have a nice piece for doll photos. I like to set up scenes for my doll photos, but I also just really like to have kind of props and things in when I do product photography for the stuff that I make. So I'm kind of just always looking for little things like this. Just trying to make sure that that's actually smooth. It is really smooth from pretty much every angle. So this is already working better than the paper clay, which is great. I'm not even sure what, like, shape of drawer pulls I want to make yet. I kind of didn't think that far ahead because I wasn't even sure this was going to work. So... But it is working really well, which makes me very happy. I have to get one of my firmer tools, though, because the only problem I'm having so far is there's just a little bit of buildup forming in between the two drawers. They're not really drawers, but they're meant to be drawers. So obviously if there's, like, a bunch of stuff in between them, it's gonna look kind of funky. So I'm going to have to take a firmer tool to smooth that out. And I might just go over the little drawer panels with the firm tool as well. Just to sort of clean it up a little bit. But that hatched really nicely over where I yanked those knobs out. Because those knobs did not come out nicely. I had to... take pliers and basically just shred them to pieces to get them out of there. So I will say that whatever glue they used on this piece was a really good glue. It holds very, very strongly. I feel like that's looking pretty good so far. So let me make sure there was... Oh, I kind of want to patch in here too because it looks really rough. Basically anything that I'm not going to be able to touch up with just paint, I'm going to use a little bit of this air dry clay. Just collect the pieces that are being brushed off. So far, I like this. This is a lot easier to work with than the paper clay, even though it is stickier. I think that's actually a benefit and not a downside. Because it is sticking to the surfaces better, obviously. So, let me turn this, tilt it up just a little bit, because I'm afraid I'm going to hit it with the end of my... smoothing tool here. So I... Oh. Wow. Oh my gosh. I'm just repeatedly amazed at how well this is working. I really wasn't expecting much from this. Yeah, so I don't really have any other plans for playing with this clay. I'm kind of just gonna play around with it and see what I can do with it. Obviously, beyond patching this and making some new drawer pulls for those front panels. I may do some more clay charms. I don't have my little templates out for my charms, so I may just kind of freehand some things and see what I can make. Hence why this is a chaos stream, because I have zero plans. It's very cold today, so I'm just
claiming that my brain is frozen. As my excuse for not planning anything ahead.
Alright, so I'll take one of my really firm ones here. And just kind of clean up these edges a bit. Really smooth it out. I want to get it kind of into the grain of the wood so that it still looks like wood. And not smooth clay. I just want to fill in those really raggedy areas on the edges there. Which so far, I feel like this is doing a fantastic job. This is way better than I expected it to work. Is that better? Okay. Getting a battery warning. I had to check on my cord. My cord wasn't plugged in right. On my computer. Okay. If that doesn't just fit the theme of a chaos stream, I don't know what does. Gosh, that's so much better. So, can I get it to focus? There we go. So it's still, you know, got a nice wood grain texture, but those edges there that were super ragged are now filled in really nicely. There's this little bit in the middle I want to kind of scratch off, though, because it kind of formed a lump right in the center. There we go. Okay, much better. So there's still this little bit right in this bottom corner that I'm going to fix. Then I'm going to move back to the front edge. Oops. So far this is the easiest clay that I have tried so far to work with. With pieces this small. So the air dry clay, or not the air dry clay, this is air dry clay too. The paper clay, it's really fibrous. So when you try to grab a small piece, you're never going to be able to get a piece this size, this smooth. And the epoxy, I think I'm just not good at it yet. Like, you kind of just have to learn to work with epoxy sculpt. So far, when I try to work with pieces of epoxy that are this tiny, all I manage to do is make a mess of my hands and get a bunch of clay under my nails. But this is going exactly where I want it to go. So, there. See that little notch is really nicely filled in now? And my hope is that because I'm really rubbing it into the wood grain, that it's going to pick up that wood grain texture and it's going to take the paint really nicely. Because I've never actually used any Sculpey brand clay at all before, so I don't have a frame of reference for how well Sculpey typically takes paint. That is one thing I do like about the air dry paper clay, is that it takes paint a lot nicer than epoxy. I usually, with epoxy, have to spray something to get it to take paint. Either MSC or like tester's dull coat. Something to give it texture, because epoxy itself tends to dry really smooth, which can be awesome, but it has really poor tooth for acrylic paints. Just further smoothing out these front bits. They feel pretty solid already, so that's kind of nice. So this is like a quick dry clay. Okay, now I'm going to just kind of try and clean up these edges here. If I can't, it's fine, because this is the underside of the table and nobody's really going to see this part. Actually use the rounded part. This is super weird, having a ring light right next to my face. I don't know how people who do this for a living get used to this. But it has to be right next to my face in order to illuminate the table. I think I may actually have to go in with my X-Acto on some of these parts here on the bottom. Because it's actually solidified already just enough that I can't. I need that little bit of separation to kind of give the illusion that these are actually drawers and not just glued on panels. So it seems like this clay dries really fast when you use super thin sheets of it like this, which is good. That's a plus for me, because most of the applications that I would have for this kind of a clay, I'm going to want quick drying results anyway. I think that's probably going to be good. Just kind of smooth it out again. Yeah. I think that looks really good. So, I know there's still like a visible shadow, but I don't feel like there's giant indentations. There is a little bit of wood sticking out from underneath the clay here that that I didn't notice before. Let me see if I can grab my needle nose pliers and try and pull that. It's probably one last little remnant of that drawer pull that didn't want to come out. And I just happened to smooth the clay in just the wrong direction to make it stand up. So I'm going to take just a little bit more. Probably half that size. It just stuck to my finger. Just gonna keep building up just teeny tiny little amounts right over the holes of where I pulled those drawer handles out of until they're perfectly level. So that there's not indentations when I sculpt on the new drawer pulls. That's probably gonna do it. I can't tell which direction pulled that little bit of wood up on that middle one, so I'm just trying to be really careful here. My camera. See, that's what I'm trying to avoid. It's one of the things I'm really looking forward to with moving is being able to have a dedicated space to do this kind of stuff so I can just set everything up and leave it and not have to move it every week. Just clean out this bottom line again. I think that's probably good. I don't see the indentations anymore, and if I kind of turn it from other angles, it doesn't look raised either. So I think we could go with sculpting new drawer holes. So now I get to find out if I can actually sculpt super teeny tiny pieces with this clay. Because I kind of want to try some skull-shaped drawer pulls. So I'm going to try and make really itty-bitty skulls with this clay.
I don't know if I'm gonna be able to.
Because these are really small drawers. Let's get out the froggy tape measure. That'll be easier to actually measure from the bottom. Yeah, so they're about one centimeter tall. So that's the whole drawer. So in order to make the drawer pull look like it's the right size, I'm going to have to go 5 millimeters. That's it. That's as big as I can go. That's going to be really tiny. My really sharp tools are in here, so that I don't stab myself with them by accident. I need my knife edge tools. Good knife? Yeah. Yes, this is a good knife. Okay, take that out too. That's the other thing I don't have is I need like a little roller to make sure that it rolls out really evenly. So this is just starting to look a little bit crumbly. I've been going for 48 and a half minutes. Okay, so I'd say probably the first 10 minutes I was doing other stuff. So you got about half an hour before this stuff starts to dry out. It still rolls up fairly smooth without a whole lot of visible cracks and stuff. So it's not dry yet. It's still sticking to my fingers, so there's that. Definitely glad that I put the silicone mat down today. Because I wouldn't be able to touch this stuff without it. It'd be all stuck to my table. Whoops! I think I'm going to have to go even smaller than that. Oh yeah, that's way too big. It'd be about half that size. Oh boy. So this is probably about the size that I want. I really don't know if I'm going to be able to get a skull out of this. I may be better off just putting little round ones on. I'm going to try, though. Okay, so I'm going to roll it up. My little knife. Oh boy. I've never tried to carve anything this small. Maybe I will try with a bigger piece to start with and just cut the little skull out of it. This is. Okay.
This could be a bit of a challenge. Alright, it is getting a little bit dried. Oil or water to re-wet it. Okay, so it doesn't actually say. Stealing a little water. Probably should have looked up ahead of time if it was an oil or water clay. I just wasn't really thinking that far ahead. Again, hence chaos stream. Okay, water works. It is now very sticky again. Okay. So, Sculpey Air Dry is a water clay. Sculpey regular, not air dry, I think is an oil clay. Alright. Kind of dab off that water there. Alright, so I'm going to start with a piece that is much bigger than what I actually need. Okay. Just kind of letting it out until it's an even thickness. I think that looks good. Alright. Here we go, attempting to carve the tiniest skull ever. So, it does still, this clay does still have kind of the fibrous texture that the paper clay I normally use has. I don't know if you can, if I can get that to focus on here. But you see when I pulled it off there, how it has, oops, come on, focus. How, there we go, how it looks almost fuzzy. So I think this one also is probably a fiber clay rather than a polymer clay. Okay. Which is, I mean, that's cool too. I know how to work with fiber clay. I mean, I'm not an expert or anything, but it's definitely not my first time working with it, so. I don't know that I'm even going to be able to carve this tiny. I might actually have a better. Might work better if I just kind of. Like, sketch the shape into the top of the clay here before I try to carve it. Oh my gosh, this is so small. And I think I might still be making it too big. I just really want to try and put skull dwarples on this table. Okay, if I can cut this shape out, as small as I just carved it, can I get this to focus? Nope. I really need to get a camera that actually focuses. This one, it was a $15 Prime Day deal. It's not a good camera. So it just focuses on whatever the hell it wants. Ooh. Don't stretch it. This is insane. I've never tried to make something this small. Oh my god! It's out. I just have to kind of reshape it because it stretched a little bit as I was trying to cut the clay. Look at this. There. That's vaguely skull-shaped, right? It stretched out the teeth, so I have to kind of... Oh no. Very carefully push the teeth back up. Oh my god, I think I can do this. I think it's gonna work. Guys, this is insane. Oh man. I'm honestly a little bit surprised that this worked. This would not have worked with my paper clay. I definitely wouldn't have been able to mold this quite so well with epoxy trying to stick to my fingers. So I'm thinking that this Sculpey clay is going to be a good investment. I actually want to make a teeny tiny little cut off of the edge here. Just tried to pick it up, and instead of picking up, it kind of smushed. Reshape the top half of the skull. Oh my god. I think this worked. Wow. Look at that. Oh my god. It's an itty bitty skull! That's so cool! Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I love this. Wow. I'm gonna put it on the middle one just in case I can't do two more of those. So that I can do round ones on the two outer drawers if I have to and it won't look super weird. Nudge it into place before I kind of press it down a little. Make sure it's centered. Oh my god, I love it. No, I may actually have to glue it. Because I think... Although, I wonder if... I'm gonna try something. There. Maybe I can get it to stick to itself.
Thank you. sort of slightly frayed brushes here. Just take one little drop of water. Because the water made it really sticky. And I'm thinking, I put extra clay on the drawer. I put some water on it to make it sticky. Yes! Edge of this blade because I don't want to smush it, I just want to press it. Make sure that it's pressed down all the way around it. Oh my god. Oh, that is so cool! Look, it's a teeny tiny skull! Oh my god, I love it! I can't believe that worked! I genuinely cannot believe that worked! Oh man, I'm so excited. Okay. Let me, I need a really tiny dotting tool. Here we go. I'm gonna try and press some little eyes into it. Nope, I need even tinier than that. Where's my needle? This is the tiniest thing I've ever tried to sculpt. I'm genuinely amazed that it worked because I've never tried to make anything this tiny. And not only did it sculpt okay, but it stuck to the drawer. Oh my god, look! Look how cool that is! Oh my gosh, I love it. Alright, let me try and take some of this excess clay from around it. Because I put a bunch of extra clay on there to get it to stick down, and now it's not as even as it was before. I'm gonna go back in with my smoothing tool. But I need a small one because I want to get right up next to it. Take a little bit of water here. I'm so excited that worked. I'm so excited that worked. Wow. It's so cute. Just going in with the dotting end of the tool. Just kind of scratching a little texture into the clay that I can't remove so that it will look like wood grain. I'm so excited about this. That came out so much better than I could have hoped. Alright, that's one drawer down. Oh my god, look at how tiny. I love it! Oh, I love it. That's perfect. I'm sorry, I just heard my phone. But I don't see my phone over here. My table's such a mess.
I can't pull it up right now. I can fix my screen now. Okay. I'm gonna see if I can replicate that two more times. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to. Because that came out way better than I expected. I'm kind of shocked. Okay, let me put another drop of water into this clay because it's starting to get a little mealy. So cute! Itty-bitty skull! Let's see if I can make one of those again. I don't know if I can. I really don't know if I'm going to be able to do that again. Before I do that. Sorry. I'm having asthma issues lately. So when that coughing starts up, I just have to use my inhaler. Okay. Oh boy. How did I do this last time? Here we go. I used this. I need to put like a pencil gripper or something on this tool because I feel like I use this one a lot. And it's kind of hard to hold on to. There's no way I'm going to be able to get this on camera, so you're just going to have to not see what I'm doing for a minute here. I don't know that this is going to work. I may have to go with just one little skull. I'm going to make at least a few attempts here, though. It just might not all be exactly the same size. Which is fine. For doll photos, I don't think anybody's going to look at it close enough to notice if they're not all exactly the same size. Alright, this one's just sticking to everything. I think I made my clay a little too sticky. Trying to get it flattened evenly before I even set it down. So what I'm noticing of Sculpey clay so far is that it seems to have a very similar texture to the paper clay I was using before, but it sticks to itself and to surfaces a lot better. So, the only thing I'm going to have to wait and see on is how this solidifies, and how well it takes paint. But I think I may just replace my old paper clay with this. Just start by cutting it out bigger than I need it. I think it'll be easier to trim down if I just get it out of the big piece. So I have sort of sketched in there, and I'm just gonna kinda try and wiggle it free. I need to get down to the bottom though, so take my needle. Sort of wiggle this bit off. There. So, I just want to kind of hold it up to that one. And it's just about the same size once I trim off all the little frayed bits. So, all the little pieces from where I wiggled it out of the bigger piece. It's also a little thicker, so let me flatten it just a tiny bit. Oh boy. Alright, I'm not worried about losing these little itty bitty bits of clay. Wasn't like extravagantly expensive. I'm just holding it by the nose right now so that I can pull all of these other little bits off. Make a little eye hole about there. Also, I am ambidextrous, so that would be why I am holding tools in both hands. There's not a lot of things, a lot of crafts especially, that I do that I actually do use both hands at the same time. But I've kind of noticed, as I've been getting into sculpting this year, that sometimes it's just easier if I use both hands at the same time. So just kind of smooth these edges. Alright, tiny skull number two. Now I just need to put a little bit of clay on one of the drawers where I want to stick it. Actually, probably half that size. Because
because I really just need enough for it to stick down. I don't want it to be raised. Because the skull is already going to be raised. So I'm going to put that. Kind of find the middle of the drawer. Oh, it's stuck to my finger. So I'm going to take, where is my flat? Here we go. My flat smoothing tool. Get it into place. A little bit of water. Get that bit wet. Just smooth it as much as I can. Drop. Okay, so it's gonna be hard to show, but the drawer is nice and wet now. So I'm going to my needle, my little needle tool. I'm gonna pick it up and pop it on there. I think it did come out just a little bit bigger than the other one, but I'm hoping that it's close enough that nobody's really going to notice that they're not exactly the same. Because the second one, yeah, it's just slightly bigger. Okay. That's two down. Oh my god, I'm loving this. This is so cute. Yeah, I feel like it's not... If you're not specifically looking to criticize it, like, I feel like it's not super noticeable that it's bigger. So I'm gonna leave it, because if I look at it too much and, like, try and fiddle with it, I'm just gonna end up breaking it. Just want to get it stuck down right now. And it's not sticking on the edges. So I'm going to take my little brush, get just a drop on there. And kind of try and drip the water underneath the skull. So that it'll get into the places that are trying to lift. And then I'm gonna just push it back on there. Okay, I think that worked. Oh, this other little one is also trying to lift, so I'm gonna do the same thing. Just kind of, oh, I knocked it off. That's okay. Back on. All is well. I just need to get. I don't know, it's probably not going to show up on the camera because the top of the table is in the way, but it's only trying to lift on the top of this skull, so I'm just kind of trying to drip a little bit of water underneath it to get that part wet so it'll stick down better. And I know my music stopped. I'm going to get it in a second. Okay, I think we're stuck back on there. Okay. Oh, I have just enough clay on my hands that my mouse pad is struggling. Okay, let's see if I can do this again. Put OBS back up. There we go.
So most air dry clay does kind of have a point of no return where you can keep wetting it and it will become malleable again, but it won't really be the texture and consistency it's supposed to have. And it seems like I'm kind of starting to hit that point with my little ball of clay over here. So I'm going to have to work kind of fast on this last one. Because I do want to do at least one little clay charm with this, just so I can have something to compare to my paper clay that I was using before. Something a little bigger than an itty-bitty skull on a doll-sized table. This is starting to get just a bit crumbly, which is okay. It is still softening up with water and kneading. It's just that the edges are starting to crumble a little bit. So. Like, see, it's still smooth in the middle, but these cracks on the ends are starting to get kind of bad. Okay. Let's see. Get my needle tool ready to pull it out of the way. This one. Whoops. Yeah, it's not even sticking to my silicone mat now. So it is getting a bit dried out. And this one.
My nose is just not getting in there well enough. Get the good knife. It's just stuck to my tool and not the mat. Oh boy. Gotta go a little bit faster. This is gonna be really hard to stick it down if it's getting that dry on the bottom already. Okay. So there's one little eye hole. The other little eye hole. Take a little tiny piece. Oh, that's very dry. That's a little bit. There we go. It's not quite as flaky. Good and wet. I wasn't being super generous with the water before, so I'm going to try and put a whole bunch of water on with this one and see if I can just stick it right down. And then I'm going to do the same thing and take the brush and just kind of drip water around it so that it gets all the way underneath so that I can really press it down into there really good. I accidentally took a little bit of a chunk out of this one's head as I was picking it up, so I'm going to try and patch that while it's wet. Okay, so there's all three on there. So I'm just gonna make sure that it's holding itself down really well on all sides before I start worrying about adding any clay to patch that area. Although maybe I can just kind of, now that it's wet, I can kind of nudge the clay that's already there back up and around so that it doesn't have a clear notch in the skull. That's That's actually working pretty well, so I'm going to do this instead of trying to patch it. Just going to kind of nudge the clay back into a round shape. I mean, if you look at it straight on, you can still tell that there's a little piece that got... I think it got stuck to my finger as I was pushing it. But if you're not looking at it straight on, I don't really think you can tell. So I'm pretty happy with that, actually. Yeah, I kind of love that. I'm really glad that came out. I didn't think it was going to work at all, so it's... automatically better than I was expecting. A couple of little rough spots here. I'm just trying to sort of shave off. Alright, I'm gonna stop messing with it now, because I feel like it looks good, and if I keep poking at it, I'm gonna ruin it somehow. I'm gonna find a way to break it, because that's just what I do. So, alright, let me put that aside. I'm gonna try and shape the rest of this. Let me just try, like, totally dunking it in the water. See if I can freehand sculpt. Maybe, like, just one of my little coffin charms. I'm not going to go get the template. I'm just going to do it freehand. I don't know if it's even going to work because I think this clay may have been dried out past the point of bringing it back. But I'm going to try. Because it's very sticky now that I dunked it in the water. And I think if I knead it just enough, I can get it... relatively smooth, if not completely smooth again. Which is also better than my old paper clay. So, I'm really liking the Sculpey Air Dry so far. Just gonna have to see how it dries. Yeah, it was getting pretty smooth, so I think I can probably still work with it. We're going for about an hour and a half, so even a really small piece set aside for an hour and a half seems to still be able to be brought back to life. Let me dunk it one more time. Because that really seemed to help quite a bit. Woo, now it's real slippery! Need that water back into it. I think I managed to bring it back. Okay, cool. So I'm going to be able to do one little charm. And then I will have something to compare as a finished product to the clay charms that I made with my paper clay. Now I will be able to give a more informed review of how this behaves compared to the other stuff when it's finished. One of the other things I ran into with my paper clay is that when I would paint it, it would get real bendy again. Not like soft, but you could kind of like flex it a little bit. So I'm wondering if this is going to do the same thing. I'm very curious to see. Alright, I think it's nice and malleable again, so I'm going to roll it up. Flatten it out just a bit and carve a little charm out of it. And I think I'm going to do a coffin because that's a pretty easy shape to freehand. Alright, so it is still just a tiny bit crumbly, so you have to knead it just enough, I think. Because when I flatten it out, it is getting crumbly. But see, when I pull it fresh out of the water and I flatten it, it's not crumbling. So I think I kneaded too much of the water out. It's nice and sticky now, so I think this is going to be the right consistency. Yeah, this feels much better. Alright, so let's... And it's sticking to the mat more than my fingers, so this is good so far. Nice smooth surface on top. Get it kind of evenly rolled out. Alright. Coffin. Kind of a big, long, skinny one. I cut this at an angle that makes it really awkward to get the top bit cut out. Okay. Just get all of the little fibery bits smoothed up to the edges here. I didn't take out. I have a needle tool, not a needle tool, a screw tool that I usually use to put the little holes for my charms. There we go. The skinny edge, just smooth that down, screw it again. I'm going to try and get it to come up without distorting the shape. There we go. All right. Oop. Just screw up those edges again. Okay, and
screw through that little section from the other side. This is just to make sure that it stays rounded and smooth from both ends. So it's kind of folding over a little bit on this side. So I'm going to go through, smooth it down. There we go. Alright, so tiny little coffin charm. I'm going to set this aside and let it dry. And then that'll be sort of my benchmark for how this stuff behaves once it's dry and when I try to put paint on it. So I'm going to have to go to that in the next one, obviously, because I imagine it's going to take a while to fully dry and cure. Okay, so I think that's going to be it for today. I didn't really have anything else planned. I made a nice big mess today, if nothing else. I think I accomplished what I set out to do. I played with my new clay. Kind of got an idea for how it behaves. I think I really like it so far. So I enjoyed playing around with that today. Yeah, you know, I dressed my dolls, I played with my clay. Talked to myself for an hour and a half. That's okay. You know, some days I just have quiet streams and it's mostly just me by myself. It's alright. Other days I have people in my chat talking. I seem to get more chatter going on in my chat box during video game streams. So, yeah, if you're watching me and you're new here, I also do video game streams on usually Thursday or Friday nights. I start at like 9:30-ish. That's Eastern time. I'm in the Cleveland area, so I'm on Eastern time. I'm planning on doing it, I think, Thursday of this week. Yeah, I'm gonna do the Thursday this week, I think. I don't have anything planned at the moment. I'm more than likely just going to be doing more indie games. Because I really... tomorrow night I want to try and refilm my first hour gameplay of Visage for the fourth time. I keep having technical difficulties as I'm trying to film it. So that still obviously isn't up. That should be up. I'm going to work on getting that posted this weekend. I'm going to try and film it tomorrow night and then do some kind of game stream on Thursday. I don't know, maybe I'll try one of the Phasmophobia clones. Like, there's a million of those out there, and as much as I want to stream Phasmophobia, I can't because it's a gigantic game file and it breaks my streams. So I don't know, maybe there's a clone I can do instead. It is, you know, getting to be Christmas time, so there's the Madvent calendar games, which, those are, it's like a game jam kind of a thing on itch.io. I might do more of the spookware, but I don't know, I'm gonna see what the Madvent calendar games are this year, because sometimes there's like Christmas themed horror games, which is kind of fun. I did one of those last time. I did Santa's Corpse is Coming to Town. That was kind of fun. It was like a Santa-themed Slender type game. So that was fun. I couldn't beat it because it was really hard. So I might try and see if there's more like Christmas horror games again. Yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do next week for the craft stream. I have nothing planned ahead at this point. Because I don't know what I'm gonna feel up to. So probably I may do more sculpting with this clay. I really, really want to try and make an art doll with clay. So, like, literally a whole doll from scratch. I want to do, like, the wire armature and, like, the foil ball head and everything. So I think I may try and start that on the next stream. Because I think that could be kind of fun. I've been watching tutorials on sculpting humanoid faces, and I don't know how good I'm going to be, as I'm sure you can tell by how much I struggled today. Sculpting's not really... I'm not great at it. I do it because it's fun, and it's actually really good occupational therapy for my hands. But it's hard, and I'm not good at it, so... I don't know. I may do that next week for the craft stream, because I feel like that could be a fun thing to try. And it'll probably come out looking terrible, but, I mean, we can have fun with that. So, I think that's the tentative plan for next week, is I think either more sculpting, or I may do more mini canvas painting, because I still have some mini canvases. So... probably one of those. If you have an opinion as to which of those you'd rather see, please feel free to let me know. Especially if you're watching this on YouTube, put it in the comments. So I'm going to be posting this stream to YouTube tomorrow, so if you missed it, that's okay. It'll be up. And if you're watching this on YouTube already, hello on YouTube. I am also on Twitch as Spooky Doll Lady, so you can go follow me over there. If you're watching on Twitch, I'm Spooky Doll Lady on YouTube as well, so I'm easy to find. But yeah, that's all I got for today, so thank you for watching. I think YouTube, I put my recommended video for you over in this corner, and the subscribe to the playlist of Crafternoon streams should be maybe over here, I think. So yeah. Go look at those. Thanks for watching. Bye!